So Tiny here, doing groundwork today, and I've got some new scary objects. I'm going to tack him up. As soon as we're done with our normal groundwork, I'm going to go ahead and tack him in his saddle. Stuff here. What are you doing? You're okay. What's the matter, huh? I'm getting nervous. There's a pool noodle and tarp there that he hasn't seen before. About. I just want him to walk up to it and smell it. We're not even going to work on this till the end of our session when he's calmed down a little bit. But this is what he's nervous about. Trying to get him to go on the car. Good. He's gonna walk around it. He's gonna understand it's not gonna eat him. As I said, this is not something I was even gonna work at yet. But he made it a big deal. I'm keeping my eye on him, but I'm not putting any pressure on him to come up this tarp. Good boy. Licked his lips. Good boy. Good boy. Walk past it. As you can see, I'm not trying to force him on the tarp. We're just walking around it. You can lunge him around it, but he's so sensitive to start with. Good boy, you're all right. You're okay. Good boy, he's licking his lips. Okay, so he licked his lips. So we're going to go away from the truck. We're going to go up here and work. Let's see if he ignores it now. Now the pool noodle he might jump away from because that's also new. So, now we're going to go back to our lead rope. He might be a little jumpier because he's paying attention to that tarp. Good boy. the pressure a little bit because I'm trying to swing it further. That's all right. Lick his lips, rub him. Good boy. There. Back his leg. He flinched a little. Just because he's cocking his leg doesn't mean he's not flinchy anymore. He'll get there. All right, so we're gonna do this side. Now, if you haven't noticed, this is his bad side. This is his bad side. So this side, he needs to get worked on triple the amount. Now, we didn't get a chance to work with him on Sunday. It was raining. So his work day got canceled. So as you see, he's gone, about 5 days without work. But he might be a little bit more antsy than he typically is, but he calmed down quite a bit he calmed down really quickly. Plus that tarp was new. Good boy. Got nervous about that, but so that's all right. Now see how he's standing right now. He's acting relaxed, but he's not. You can definitely see that. He's tense. A little bit on the tense side today. We may not tack him up. Now my lead rope wrapping around his one ankle, he was nervous about. Go for it. Nope, you're on it. Okay. You need to get around him a little bit. Not that good. That might be an uphill work. Switching a little bit. That's all right. Stay still. Good boy, Tiny. Good boy. Still be watching that tarp a little bit. I'm gonna turn him. A little bit splayed out there. I don't like that. I think he's ready to jump ship. Again, this is his bad side, so this side should get double the amount of work when he goes home. Anytime he's being trained. Oh boy. Stop.
stick and string here. Hang on. We'll do the training flag here. Oh no! What was that? He's been pretty good with the training flag. But again, we haven't worked for a few extra days here. So now it might make him a little bit nervous. So then we kind of start from square one until he gets good with it. Rub him all over with it. Make sure he's not afraid of it. This will help with anything that touches him on the saddle that he's nervous of. Have the feel of it, you know. Gotta get up on that hill again, huh? Now you're standing. Now, see, now he doesn't like the training flag touching his belly. So that's something that'll have to be worked on. What's up with that, huh? I'm gonna start. See how that makes him? He's got his leg cocked because he knows he's not supposed to move. He knows he's supposed to relax, but the way he's standing, go a little back further on his belly. Good boy. Is this a horse I can put a back cinch on? Probably not. Those are spots that he has to have work done when he goes home, where they will never go away. Now, is he going to do it on this side? Probably. Each side is different. Now he stopped, but he's not relaxed. 15 seconds if he doesn't relax. But he's got to stand still. Go back a little further. Just huffed out a sigh of relief. Good boy. And his leg is cocked. This is all new to him, though. We haven't done this before. Good boy. Good boy. Go back to something he's comfortable with. There, now he's got it. Now he's not concerned. He knows I'm not trying to eat him. Now, is his chest an issue? In between his legs? Nope, that's good. Good boy. Sometimes that'll be. Good boy. Good boy, huh? Okay, now I'm going to do the front of him. Just do the front of him. That would have killed him last time. Rattle paddle. We'll just do it just because he's a little bit antsy today. But he could really. Let's see what it is. doesn't bother him that much. It's okay. Well, I could be wrong. Now, do I touch his belly with it is the question. Big side. Good boy. Good boy, huh? See, now the belly doesn't bother him too much. All right. This is the biggie. This is the pool noodle. Now the pool noodle he hasn't done yet. So. Pool noodle is new. It's new, it's scary, it's red, it's foam. Seen a pool noodle before? Huh? First thing I do, desensitize there. It doesn't make any noise, but it's a big scary object. They touch you with it? Oh, good boy. He's like, whatever. Oh, the hip. Got a different texture to it. Something you could beat on him with. Don't beat on him, but you know what I mean. Tap him gently with it. You can get used to that too. I'm not gonna hurt him. Good boy. You tap it well. Good boy. This is a bad side. Oh no, it's gonna eat him. It's gonna eat you. Oh, he's sick. Come here. Now. He's gonna eat you. Usually the face is the worst, but it's always his left side. Good boy. There, I licked his lips, so I'm gonna go to this side. Now I bet you when I start tapping him, it's gonna be an issue. No, he licked his lips. Good boy. Let me touch his belly, baby. Or it might be an issue. Oh, now see how he's camped out. You're goofy. Come here. I mean, this may seem stupid, you know, is a pool noodle going to eat him? Are you ever going to come across on a trail? No, but the more you desensitize him with scary objects that they never see before, the less likely he's going to spook at something stupid, you know? That pool noodle might eat him. Just the texture of it. It might get him. Okay, tarp. Go back to this mean old tarp down here. Good boy. He's having a heart attack over there.
fly because it's making noise. One thing you can do with a horse like this too is I'm trying to make him come to the tarp. Okay, maybe he doesn't want to come to the tarp. Fine. Brain to fall out of his head. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to lunge him for a little bit here. And we're going to lunge him. And as we lunge him, he's going to get close to the tarp every time. Eventually, he may step on the tarp. He may freak out. You know, I'm not too worried about any of that.